No.
I think that's what he was talking about. And I felt like Perch manipulated the last tournament because we were called Perch Get Down first.
So you got three shitty models.
So we got three shitty models and they got like Sand Gyro and Naga Siren.
Nah, I don't think so, man. You're overthinking too much.
I'm not sure, man, but because I never saw a one-sided model lineup like that before.
Is there something insane with the Venge Aura?
Yes.
Not really. There's Chainfrost. Yes. Chainfrost with the Bound.
I mean, he's Spirit Breaker first pick. He's gonna get a stun on Spirit Breaker, right? And then right
quick. Oh, charge.
I hope he gets charged, yeah.
I got charged.
Yeah, charged. It's a star.
Charged better than some.
Also, yeah, I think they value charge a good bit.
Yeah, you know them, right? So I think Chuck. Also, Spirit Breaker has.
I mean, there's still Stormhammer, there's still Chaos Bolt, there's a lot of stun. Okay, it's getting charged.
Oh, Vengeance Aura. There's two things that. Yeah, see?
I mean, he can get like Phantasm on Venge and be pain in the ass.
Yeah, that's kind of what I expected from Lanes. I think they're going to give him like a really ambiguous first pick, and then they're probably going to go into like Goo Warpath for the second round of picks for him.
First pick Quill on CK, that's weird.
That's really cheap, man. There's Stormhammer, holy crap.
Yeah. I think that those are... Lich and Pango are just going full stun now. They're going Stormhammer, Chaos Bolt, Venge, maybe rolling on Pango. Maybe Pango gets like Chaos Bolt and Rolling Thunder.
I think they leave Rolling Thunder for Sven because he has the Phantom.
Nah, I think he's going the second core. Yeah, see Chaos Bolt and Rolling. And Strah goes maybe Meme, Stifling Dagger with Impetus. Loop.
I could see them leaving the Rolling Thunder for the Spirit Breaker too.
I think it's really good on Pango with the talents. The 3 second duration rolling thunder duration is really good. I would pick it on Pango. Okay, Soulbind, no, decent pick. Tech is getting a setup for his suicide. I mean, it has a setup for his suicides. Lich.
Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of damage very early into the lane.
Is there something insane with Swash? Maybe the Klee? Impetus, right.
Whoops.
That's a killer combo right there.
So what is Space going like Stat and Goo, Warpath Goo? And is Shadow Fiend going Necromastery or Phantasm first? I wonder.
I think he's going to get Necromastery.
Phantasm.
He's just afraid of
it. Yeah, but Wench can still get the Necromastery and Requiem if she wants to.
Oh,
on the way back, Wench can pick the Necro. Yeah, he's gonna get his bash on Spirit Breaker and... Like you said, maybe the rolling, right?
Yeah, it seems like the best thing for him based on like
other trying
to utilize the Necro roll.
And you can still charge during roll, as far as I remember.
Yeah, a lot of those mobility spells are really broken with Rolling Thunder.
Blur on Shadow Fiends, I would say. Blur, please get Blur. Thank God. And he's maybe gonna counterpick the Goo on CK just because he doesn't want it on Sven. Yeah. And Sven Bulldoze, I would say.
Yeah.
Wow.
Bulldoze.
Wave of Terror isn't too bad for him.
He's maybe just going for utility. Yeah. Okay. Lucky Shot is never bad with Swash.
Yeah.
Triple raise with a setup stun is great.
The Warpath Tech early kind of put him into a corner. That
Tech is Sparkwrath.
Man, I really like Tech spill.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's kind of
that's insane damage.
It's nice.
Yeah, it's a lot of control too.
Never underestimate the Enchant, which is a dispel too. So you can dispel like Shield Crash, Frost Shield, what else? Nothing else.
And this is the strongest lane support spell in the game. You just get the big creep at the one
mark. And be annoying as fuck. Yeah. What is he getting?
Usually you want to block the big camp at safe lane support, but with that spell, the enemy wants to block it because the creep is so strong.
And we have mines. We have mines in the game. And Frost Blast is really strong on Lich with the talents. Crit on Arc just also for the break, but he's never getting close to Shadow Fiend, so maybe.
Man, imagine if Lich can stun like two people with the Storm Hammer and drop of the Gem Frost.
I think he should have left Rift to Spirit Breaker, and he should have picked the Warcry. But it's okay. He's not taking his Presence Aura! I think a presence would have been better. Yeah.
I mean the shard on the wave tower gives him more damage. So
yeah, it's only one negative armor difference.
Is he getting the shard? For what? Just for the wave?
I think the thing you're missing out though is for the talents, because XF really makes good use of the presence talents.
Wait.
Yeah, and presence has a really good win rate.
Why is Spirit Breaker not getting Warcry for more?
But I think the drafts overall are still balanced, so I wouldn't say that this game gonna be a stomp or something.
Yeah, there's a couple of characters.
Shit, I forgot to turn off the music.
The G2OP guys, but overall it's like pretty in flavor with what they like to draft.
I like the supports on Radiant better, but the cores on Dire are strong.
And Lich is a disgusting support. Triple raise with a setup stun.
Yep.
Yeah, I think it's the Lich and the Techies are both going to have a lot of fun this laning phase.
Yeah. It's going to fuck them hard. So, let's put the casting overlay.
So how do I do this? I mute you in Discord?
Why? You can mute this. Why? You can mute the stream.
Because I'm watching the stream, I left the game.
Mute the stream.
You can go in game and you can choose my broadcast option. Yeah, whatever. But then it's a few seconds delay, just so you know. Okay, let's see the lanes.
Your broadcast.
No. Broadcast. It's not. I left the broadcast, so you won't see it on the broadcast.
I can watch the game you are watching.
You can do that, yeah, but then you don't see my camera movement, but that doesn't matter.
No.
So, we have Lich mid. I didn't expect that. I thought it's Lich support, but Lich mid, safe lane Shadow Fiend, support Pango bot.
Well, Lich build is really strong.
And Space is off lane, farming with Spirit Breaker support.
Yeah. Spirit Breaker would be a position 4, he will chat a lot around the map.
Majora mid?
I don't know. Look,
where is it?
Radiant has 2 stun. But the Dire team has also really good early game spell, so I'm kind of curious how it will go.
Yeah, they're going on Techies. Are they able to kill him?
He's gonna blast off.
He's charged, but they won't reach him.
Oh, don't go back. Nice.
And is he committing to more quills?
I think they know the sentry right there. I think they would deward that.
Yeah, they dewarded already.
That's a mistake. They dewarded against enchant. That's not good. That's gonna fuck him up.
That's the Strah Award. That's the fucking Strah Award. On the bot lane. Oh my god, why is it?
Perch committing top, spins a little low.
Cameraman. Top.
Well, nobody is dying top. I was just confused a bit by the boots first, Shadow Fiends. Isn't that
he has
weird?
A wave terror. That's a really good farming spell.
Okay. I mean, Shadow Fiend has the shitty base damage, but no matter. Let's see. Ultra Law 6 last hits already.
Man, Shadow Fiend's really confident with his last hit, man. To be honest.
Oh, the game is running already. I see.
Yeah. Bot lane, we have Tech is lurking in the... Oh, and they get the
courier kill.
And he suicides in, and they're gonna get Shadowfiend. And he's gone. You've just achieved first blood. That's suicide play. Not just threatening the nukes, they are nuking the Russians.
Get last hit by 39 damage.
Ooh, is he gonna get quill straight to death? No.
Nice, they force him to.
They cancel the salve on Pango with techies. Feels bad.
They forced him to skill early. The field first.
I mean, those two teams are not fucking around. They are going at each other. They want to know who's the best.
Can you get a kill here in the bottom lane? Yep.
Oh,
nice and easy from the techies.
Yeah, first he cancelled the salve, then he suicides. Man. Beautiful.
I'm so sad.
Self-canceled it up for that.
I'm so sad about the cameraman. Holy fuck.
Fuck you.
He missed out the action.
I missed only one kill. One out of two, 50%. I'm more interested in mid lane, how Mashor is going to play this. Is it just... Because you cannot play against this Lich. Look at him. He's gonna fuck you, no matter what. And he's just getting the small creep, so... Don't be... blinded by the... If you look at the net worth, he's 70 gold ahead already. Yeah. Loot.
So there's a question.
Really? Stop! He's TPing out! And he's making it.
Okay.
So triple race! One, two! Oh, he didn't have... He had a third race on Lich and didn't use it. That would have been a kill.
He doesn't have the time.
Yeah, I think it was like he's running out of range, right?
Yeah.
So he's out on bot lane. They're committing. He has sticks ready, but is it enough? Yes, it is enough.
Wow. We have a mango for the stun. He's got that anyways.
No. Sex ray, he says. Okay. So let's wait for this ray.
So guys, that's a really good question from the Twitch chat. Like, what do you guys think about Venge Aura with full passive?
Is it I don't like the Venge build. I think it's a horrible.
Depends.
He doesn't even. Let's say it like that. Yeah. He doesn't have to play around the Venge Aura. He's
exactly.
It's just about damage in this part.
Yeah,
but
it's just.
It's not a real like Venge Aura build. Yeah. No, it's not.
It's like carry with two lives, basically.
Yeah, and also they want also to pick the Venge Aura first to come to pick them. And if something good coming back to him, maybe he's gonna pick the active spell. But he saw there's a lot of passive spell to carry this game. I think why not?
And Vengeful Spirit used to be one of the top hero models you can get, but they nerfed her stats gain quite a lot, so she's not. Best hero model anymore, but she's still
really
decent.
Easy tunnel vision on the Aghanim's aspect of the ability, whereas you know even before that was introduced, the Venge Aura as a passive was pretty strong just for carries anyways. So I don't think it's like the worst thing to utilize in that regard. And he did get you know God Strength with it, so if he goes in Aghs eventually, he's gonna have a really really strong illusion. But
yeah, and he also gets the bonus souls.
And he's stacked for himself, but Godbud knows it. And he's... What? Stunning the illusion! Oh, getting the kill and stealing the stack. Godbud, we know why he's the god of NA Dota.
God, I love.
As a Peruvian, but...
God. Why? Why? That's not necessary.
But he's still going in. Is he fucking up? No, he's chain frosting them.
Oh my
getting
god.
Getting still that's... one kill as
this is my rope right there.
Yeah, they won't secure the CK, but that was nice.
Man,
beautiful.
Like you say before, the control of tech is insane. Like stun and with the sucky $5. Amazing.
But the thing
yeah,
is,
it feels good as support to get like two really good control spells.
Yeah.
The thing is, does the Lich fall off at some point? I think so. At least he's not gonna be as impactful as he's right now. So, Right now, no hero on the map is stronger than this Lich.
His peak is level 7.
Yeah, he is level 7.
Raises, and from that point on, he's gonna fall off.
Yeah. But he has it now. He has it now. He can even kill when chased. The Stormhammer setup is enough to triple raise. And he's gonna do it! Scott by God! Boom! And additionally, we get Space killing the Arc Warden. And on bot, we have some action. Damn. Everything happening at the same time in this game.
Cowboy really, really low. Looks like he's gonna head back.
He has to head back, but he has Aura of Corrosion. Interesting choice.
How do you guys call him? Code him in team, like in Discord, like Cowboy or George?
Oh, we just call him Cowboy usually.
Ah, Casey.
Big player.
I don't know. Someone told me that his name is
George. Lenske. Just call him George.
Oh my god. Man, this Lensko.
It's even his name.
Just
is...
like he... No, it's not his name.
His name is George Georgery Smith. It's official.
George Bush from Texas.
George Georgery Smith.
It's true. Yeah. It's true.
Absolutely true.
So we have bot lanes on aggression by the Enchants. Big tornado, but he cancels it. Why did he cancel the tornado?
Oh, he missed the third raise. He turned.
Oh, I didn't see that one.
Oh my god, I'm gonna watch my game by myself.
No, I didn't. I don't miss anything. I'm watching it perfectly. Top lane, big play on ultra low. Zero range. Impetus swash. And he's getting shielded.
That's not good.
A Space says, "Fuck you, bitch." I still get you.
He's gonna go ham.
Oh, no, he needs vision, No, Space dead. And they get another one and he's dead.
Davai.
And Alu Akbar on the Spirit Breaker sucks him back. And he's gone too.
Here comes the sucky $5. Bam! He got the last hit again.
Yeah, that was really sucky
$5. Oh, God by God! 1, 2, 3, and dead!
First... Damn, God play. Dagger first item. Guys,
I think you, Haru, I think you're like 3 seconds or something behind me. You have to maybe watch the game and just do your
it's true. I'm on camera right now
and your own camera control. Otherwise, you're just behind the pits all the time.
We got 4 heroes for Radiant heading top into the 3 of the tire.
Yeah, Space cocky as fuck. Going in, is he getting punished again? The charge, God by God, in, raises him. Then there's Straha getting fucked too. But what can the Tekkis do? He doesn't have mana for suicide. Okay, he sticks and gets raised by God by God.
The Tekkis did clean up the Pangolier before a lot of that stuff broke out.
But even, I mean, gold wise, we are even here. It's like 700 gold leads. Yeah. Space going for Echo Saber first. I guess that's okay-ish.
And to be honest, I thought the bench will have really good farm, you know?
God, but fucked him hard! Mashor!
Yeah.
Underestimates.
The triangle is pretty big for God Beloved.
Mashor is doing the classic Russian thing, which is farming. Yep, oh, but God, but God, bomb! 1 race, 2 race, 3 race, dead!
And even haste on the on top. Now they can get mid lane.
30 seconds to think about his life choices there.
Maybe you should pause and ask any last word.
Godba even has a blink.
Oh.
And Mike Nolan, I mean... Oh. The thing about Shadow Fiend is, like, he's really weak. Early game, because he has a shit stats game. Oh my god. Space going in.
Oh, he's too fast.
That's the power of 3 mobility spells.
Yeah, but he should put more levels in Phantom Strike, I think. The 5 seconds.
I'll agree. I would have maxed Phantom Strike over Reality Rift, but I'm not.
I mean, Reality Rift is better in lane because of the minus armor, but Phantom Strike is more versatile because you can use it defensively.
You can blink to anything.
Yeah.
And it scales also with attack speed and with the cooldown, 5-second cooldown. Sheesh.
Yeah, it's insane with the war path.
Yeah, it's a really good build on space.
Yeah, it's definitely your lowest cooldown mobility option.
But I also like to use... I mean, you can use Phantom Strike more for farming than Reality Rift.
What do you think about the Echo Saber though? Okay, maybe with...
He needs some sort of mana region. He needs some sort of mana region. And you don't have to underestimate the... Double Soulbind Chainfrost! Storm Ammo! Poof!
That was brutal.
Goodbye.
I thought Storm Hammer, Dipper Storm Hammer, but the Chainfrost on top was like...
Oh,
okay,
Shadow Fiend in trouble mid, getting Suki-suked. It's not enough. Godbush already shows up. I mean, what we have to keep in mind this game is, like, even if it looks like Radiant is in full control of the game right now, it's still like, don't fucking underestimate the disgusting player Mashor is. He finds space, everywhere. He gonna be fucking big this game.
He will focus for late game for sure.
After playing against them, it felt a lot of that way. Like, we could have been ahead in the early game, but they were really good at stabilizing in the mid and then pulling ahead through the late game. And I think they have a lot of tools right now, especially with, like, the remote mines are really good at slowing the game down.
Mm-hmm. At some point, he's gonna be such a disgusting carry. It's like, it's really strong, that build.
And it's Hedgehog. He's really good with the mines, too.
Yeah, but he's dying right now, but...
No.
Strahd at 2.
Featuring.
I'd kind of like to see a Hex come out on Godbelove, maybe after this Aether Lens, just to really make sure his disable ability is like scaling so he can kind of contest this bench when they're in fights a bit more.
Mm-hmm.
Once he gets
I'll agree. I'll agree. Blink Hex on Venge. Pretty strong, but Venge queuing up the Dragonlance and a PKP afterwards, so I'll agree with that too.
Yeah, that's pretty expected.
And once we reach that point that Venge has like a lot of stats, and a PKP, she can clear the Shadowfiend illusions. And she can deal with all the nuke damage that...
Do you guys think that the Shadowfiend will get Aghanim Scepter anytime soon?
That's a free one.
The Shadowfiend?
Yeah,
he should.
Blur and the global, I mean the Chaos Tech, the Chaos Illusion.
I disagree with his choice to get a Shadow Blade. Dragonlance first, maybe into Manta, into Scepter, something like that.
He really appreciates how many of them are here right now around him, but...
Oh, big fight happening at
the... They're gonna get the backline.
Separate fight breaking up by the tower.
Beautiful charge.
Oh my god, that's wash.
Oh my god. But they get the techies. CK still on top of the Shadow Fiends.
Nice swap.
Ian got a fight here. Space killing the Ark, but dying himself. And Mashor getting a double Q on his Venge. To recover.
Nah, he's not gonna catch him. This guy gonna chart.
And look, he's still doing 420 damage.
I think Radiant got way too separated from each other there, especially the Ango with the Lich. Those two need to focus on staying near each other in the fights to really maximize the burst they're dropping on this Dire team.
Really not sure if the build Shadowfiend is going for can out-carry the Venge. That's my...
He has so much damage at minute 15, man. 250 plus damage.
Godbug going for Kaya.
Xenocide,
I still agree fully with you on Godbush should get a Hex. It's really, really, really strong against the major threat that Dire has, which is the Wench. Blink, Hex, Raise, Stun after the
Storm
when the Hex is...
Yeah,
it's like 5 second control on the Wench, which otherwise gonna just BKB. And Blink, Hex, you cannot BKB that. Blink, Stormhammer, you can BKB that if he is a, if he's really fast.
Wench top net worth now, by the way.
Oh,
yeah,
behind.
like I said, never fucking underestimate the Mashor, what he can pull off.
Rope was right, the Lich is falling off right now, it's so hard.
Yeah, it's still not bad, once the BKBs are off.
Sorry?
I think the Kai is just kind of redundant, you know, it just makes him slightly better at what he's already doing. It's not giving him a new facet that's helping him answer what the Dire is building for him.
Mm. Yeah, that's nothing. He doesn't need it at all.
Maybe he wants quick burst. That's what his goal is right now.
He's already
got it. But the 8% spell amp won't help you burst anyone.
Wanted like another burst item, maybe an E-blade is a better avenue for him.
Yeah, true. That's really strong. Holy fuck.
Doesn't count the BKB Wench. And once Wench just has to press BKB, press the ult. And look at her damage, it's gonna be...
Yeah, she's gonna have sick damage.
Fucking 1 billion!
Blade instead of Kaya, he can use it defensively as well. And just kite the BKB. Runaway Ghost formed, Blink out.
Yeah,
Ghost... Kaya does nothing for him. And what's the build-up he's gonna do with Kaya? Sanj Kaya?
Maybe, just for the...
Yeah, so it's like 200 more HP, sick. And some self resistance.
320.
It's okay against the techies, but that's about it.
Yeah.
I think I'd like to see some more smoke attempts coming off of the Radiant side right now.
I missed it also, man. I did see a smoke.
Both teams lost their confidence to go on each other at the moment, and they're like, just okay, we have the better late game.
That strictly benefits the Dire.
I would say so too. I think Dire has the better late game in this game.
Yep.
Just between the mines and how well this Venge is like really dodging and continuing to scale even after like the early ganks and the deaths to Godbelove, it's just looking better. Like this gold lead hasn't grown at all for the Radiant right now, and that's a big problem.
And he's going Silver Edge on Shadow Fiends.
Follow up with block question about the Shadow Blade. So now he makes Silver Edge to break the...
Yeah, but what? The CK? Bag.
The Bristol Bag, yes! Look!
Yeah,
look.
Is it worth it?
Oh my god.
He can break the Bristol Bag and he can also break the Vengeance Aura, so he doesn't get an illusion after dying.
Oh! They get the CK, but they are paying with...
Venge is
one,
from
two.
The side. They don't see the Venge. Venge is gonna kill him from behind.
Okay, look at the Venge damage. Look at the Venge damage!
Cleaning service.
He's getting Shadow Blade and
double kill. Holy
3, 4, 5.
He was
and instantly going for Roche with his activated God Strength.
Literally a vacuum
disgusting.
Cleaner right there.
Disgusting the Russians. Let's see. We have like decent advantage for
Dire.
The
Radiant
losing fight.
1 to 2 heroes to these mines every fight, and a lot of time, like very early into the fight, so these heroes aren't able to get the full rotation of their spells off.
The thing is also, they didn't get off the Soulbind Chainfrost combo. They soulbinded one hero, but he was like not binding to another one, and got but died, I think. No. And still, don't underestimate on all the heroes that don't have a BKB or any mobility to jump out. Soulbind plus Chainfrost is disgusting. The Wench can survive it, but...
And just like that, we jump from a 1k gold lead for Radiant to a 2k gold lead for Dire.
No.
It's nothing. At 20 minutes.
It's pretty close still. It's like anyone's game, but...
We've had... 5 minutes.
I still don't think that Silver Edge was the play on Shadow Fiends. That was... He can still come back with Scepter and like Skadi. Yeah. Oh, I missed that kill. Okay, fight happening, and they go on the Venge, which just dies after popping the ult, so she doesn't have anyone to do respawns.
Here's two life. Say, two life.
CK stun. Oh, beautiful chain frost!
Nice combo.
Oh my god, space going in, but there's only Agwon left. He's wrestled. Beautiful.
Yeah, the
chain frost.
That pushed him on the high ground.
Yeah, they swapped Tango and it just bumped him perfectly.
Beautiful play by the NA stack.
Alright, it's good to see some confidence and some life still in the G2OP, guys.
That was a big fight for them. They got Aegis! They got Aegis! Yeah. Got the Aegis, just look at it. 3k, 7k XP, just look at the graph now. Chakapoo!
He went straight for the third item, Arcanum Scepter. More illusion. That will be amazing.
I like it. I like it. The only problem is like the Wench can clear, if she gets her stuff off, she can clear illusions pretty well. But it was like, I think she got stunned here before she BKB'd, and he Shadowfiend casted his illusions already and was hitting the Wench, and she couldn't recover from that.
She got bumped onto the high ground, and it was a deer in headlights moment where suddenly the whole cliff was separating her from the team, and the Radiant did a really great job responding onto that.
Mm-hmm. I think, what does Wench need to fight back on this? I think MKB might be okay, but I think she needs to swap out the Mask of Madness for Satanic.
Yeah.
Because she... most of the time she's gonna get bursted and has to recover from that, and the only way to do that is Satanic. Especially with the build she has.
Yeah, but you don't heal with Satanic if you don't hit the target. That's why he buys...
MKB first, yeah. After MKB, the Satanic.
Yeah, because he has to contend with the Blur and the Magnetic Field, which has been like... It saved a couple people, for you know, bought them some time in the fight so far, so it's a decent option to work against it.
Yeah, I agree.
There's also an item, Groove Bow, for the Radiant. I don't know why the Seraphine didn't use it, because like you have Blur and you want to stay far away to hit people, right?
Oh! Bondini dies here. I mean, what we still have to point out is like they have the Swash with Impetus combo, but it's really bad against the illusion build that Raiden is going for, because you're gonna waste your whole mana pool with one Swash Impetus combo.
To be honest, the Arth Warden is kinda poor. Look at this network.
Yeah, true.
So after the Kaya, we ended up getting a Yules on God Below. And now he's going into a Ghost Scepter.
Yeah. True.
Nice.
Space to go in, for sure.
I think they want to fight here. Big fight happening. Oh, Wench! Getting swapped out, but they gonna get swapped by it. Chain Frost, boom, boom, boom. Bam, boom. And
look at the damage.
But the Wench is still fucking strong. Damn it, no.
Oh my god.
For a moment I thought Radiant would win that fight, but then the Wench was starting to hit.
Yeah,
and she has
the swap were massive there. For the dead. And they got the full combo off too with the Soulbind and all of God Love spells too.
Yeah. But he has his MKP and his BKP on Wench.
Hello's there.
Hey.
Who are you?
Yeah.
Who is this?
We are casting the game.
Here in, yeah.
Yeah.
It looks like Cowboy's gonna be finishing up his halberd soon once he respawns and gets to farm the rest of the
Oh, he's the guy who wanna jump, so he needs to put halberd on the vent.
Yeah. I mean, it's a smart choice. They maybe even need a second halberd on, like, yeah, okay, they're going for a second halberd on Spirit Drake.
One for one, too.
Right choice, I would say. Oh, he's charging, but he finds the... Was he smoked on... Possibly
so. You guys were curious about what he would be going for after the MKB, and it looks like he's got a butterfly queued up now.
Fucking Hedgehog is going for his signature play, placing mines in the dead spot of the Roche pit. Bondini places a sentry, but he that's actually a good counter to that Sparkwraith. Because this is, for people who don't know, Roche has a weird interaction on the vision. We go to Radiant, you don't fucking see the mines here. Oh, big fight happening. Tech is dead.
Look at
that. Shadowfiend has his scepter, 1 billion illusions. Is Mashor dying? Nope, he fights back and he's still dead. Once his... Yeah, this is a big fight for Radiant. Three dead already on Dire.
I think they're into the mines.
Yeah.
PA trying to escape here.
Baited,
they're pinging it, for sure, pinging it like crazy, the mines. And they get Strah on top.
They know.
Yeah, CK, the lone survivor there. Oh, they want more.
They want him. They want him. Can they get
the break?
Goblins break. Got the
Bro is broken and he's...
Bomb.
Dead.
Bomb.
Oh, my god, and Bondini is surviving on the... On 100 HP.
That is a fucking worth death on CK right there, man.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Baiting them into the mines.
Killing two cores.
Plus one and two, yeah. Fucking
Radiant
worth.
Needs to be really questioning if they want to take another fight, I think, without a gem.
Yeah, disgusting mines, man.
Yeah.
This guy is doing
he
really
knows.
Great
he knows how to play with mines. This. Level 18 also already, and I think it was like plus 4 or something. Go to
Four.
It.
Deadly was dead when he killed them with the mines red, was he? I don't know. Did he get the XP from that?
For no, he was dead. He was dead.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's unfortunate, but still.
What are your thoughts on this Arc Warden's itemization?
MKB max damage, I guess, with the swashbuckler.
No, he wants to clear all the illusions with one swash. I think that's his goal, and I think he's right with that choice. It's not a bad idea.
I think he's greedy and he doesn't know what he want to do.
Yeah, but MKB is.
Yeah,
MKB is
good. It's good with swash and it's good against a blur.
Yeah, and he wants to. I think if they have something
they
like that, if they
on Sven.
If they have a solution like that to clear all the illusions on, Radiant, that's not bad.
Yeah.
I need to go back, right?
So, Shadowfiend going for Skadi next. Okay.
Spake gonna make his AC.
Yeah, he queued it up before. What is the last core? Yeah, Godbun now finally going for the Hex.
Yeah, we've got Venge finished with the Butterfly.
Looks like Dire wants to smoke, or what's this play? Yeah, they want to smoke. Want to clear, and they are smoking. We're going to see a big fight happening soon.
Killing spree.
But first!
They get to start
first,
the fight
mine the
damage.
Mid.
Okay, they have the gem on Starfiend.
Yeah, but look at the wraparound. Going through the triangle. Got the getting instantly killed. Yeah, he cannot get out of this.
That's a good range.
And they don't have any follow up for this.
Okay,
so
Halberd use.
All the illusions are cleared. Yeah, they should chill on Radiant now till they are back to... Nice smoke play by the Russians.
That was beautiful, botch, yeah.
Roche up in 40 seconds. Maybe that's like the... Ah, okay, it's gonna respawn on Lich. Once
more. The sprung on Agnes Scepter on CK does do anything on melee hero?
The sprank? I don't think.
Yes, sprank.
So. It's doing nothing than dispelling yourself. If I'm not. Or is it even dispelling you? I don't
No,
remember.
It's dodging incoming projectiles.
Oh. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. So, Radiant checking Roche, setting up some... And they see that Roche is up. Dire still doesn't know, but now they put in a mine. And both teams know that Roche is up. The next big objective there.
They smoke under Vision Ward. That is not good.
Yeah. That's unfortunate.
And they probably want to go in on Roche. Casting the Elos and... That's the call for Dire. They have MKP finished on Arc Warden. He's just going to clear up all the illusions in one swash. Look at it go. Okay, don't even commit swash for this.
Okay.
Triple raise on Wench, but she's fine. PKP, but now she doesn't have PKP anymore.
SF and Pango getting zoned off just by this CK.
Oh, good.
Oh, the slowest charge I've ever seen in my life.
Oh my god.
Tech is sacrificing his life for the Spirit Breaker.
Are they gonna get Roshan? Are they?
Really difficult to find a path to victory now for the Radiant here.
Yeah.
I think the fight conditions like that they have to find to be able to win the fight are super specific. And, you know, they obviously can't. The way that smoke gank the last fight started was perfect for them. The Dire, just they got a free pick off before it even started. They got an upper advantage right around back. Like, they have way more ways to, like, get in and start good engagements for themselves than the Radiant does right now.
And Wench even gets a free shard right now. Those who don't know, it's a crit every 3 seconds for consumption of one soul. But you get 2 charges on Necro for each last hit you get. So, still pretty good. Can leave it on autocast actually. Yeah, this looks hard for Radiant to come back into this game. But they're still not out, because they have big team fights.
Yeah, neither team's really made a huge priority on, like, just pushing the objectives. They've all been a lot more content to play their side of the map, and it's just been slowly benefiting the Dire more and more.
Don't have reveal on Dire.
Holy shit.
Yeah, the illusions just get cleared up right now.
Yeah, Techie's done such a good job conditioning them to just be afraid to try and push over the river.
The Venge has like 500.
Yeah. It's escalated quickly. This escalated quickly when we look at the graph.
And Ghost Rank will be more and more.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Tier 2 bottom is down.
Radiant has not had to contend with an Aghanim's on the Venge yet, so, you know, there's that super late game inevitability where they're now going to have to deal with the, you know, second life on the Venge too.
I think Wench doesn't buy an axe, she just waits for...
Yeah.
For Roche.
For the Roche.
Next Roche to drop one for her.
Vance has
base going in, but... That's not enough. Chain Frost into... Oh! But... He has a BKB on CK. Wench dropped her casted Satanic. Doesn't have a follow-up, they get the Aegis.
Oh
but
my god.
But then they get sucked and they just fucking die. Shadowfiend no buyback and he's down.
They're
trying to get the wench, but I think Bondini is just dead and now they're gonna clean up the rest of Radiant.
Yeah, these swaps have just been on time all game.
Yeah. Nice place by Dire, I have to say. Beautifully executed, and we just look at the gold graph. We were. What time is this? Like. 5 minutes? 5 minutes ago it was pretty even, and right now we are looking at a 25k gold advantage for Dio. Space,
yeah, I
also
don't think that Raiden have any chances to do anything now already.
Also, Space is struggling to get another item.
He's choking.
Theorin, your mic sounds really, really bad. By the way.
Yeah. He queued up like AC for like 10 minutes already?
Yeah, that's like I said, he made no progress in the last few minutes. Wow. Did he commit buyback? Yeah. I mean, if you have a look at the buybacks right now, it's like...
Yeah, he's got all this mobility, but it's so hard for him to A, do any damage in the first place, but B, stay on top of like these targets. He's got, you know, the range finish to contend with, he's got Swash on the Arc Ward that can just create a lot of space. Going on CK is a pretty fruitless endeavor. And then he's always, you know, if he gets close to anybody, there's a PA sitting in the back ready to like swap the target out.
And there's zero buybacks available.
Oh, mid.
Radiant right now.
Yeah. Man, you saw a bottom fight.
What? Oh, what happened here? Where? Two people getting blown up by their mines. Oh, okay, yeah. I think that was pretty much GG. They have don't have buybacks. Now even Bondini dies.
Two cores down.
Three people down with all the buybacks.
Neither of these heroes can really have the range to repel anything unless he just wants to toss down his ultimate with the Chain Frost, but...
Last chance, Chain Frost into...
There's
just
no chance
BKB.
For...
He Chain Frosts, hoping to accomplish something, and he gets zero kills and just dies.
Oh, he swapped out again.
Oh, he
perfect. Doesn't
die. I mean, it was a desperation attempt by Penguin. Lich, nice combo, but not enough to...
950 damage on the vent. What is this?
That's insane.
What is this, man?
Now I was doubting that build. I mean, he was getting fucked early game, let's be honest. Godbus showed him who's boss, but we knew that Mashor is gonna come back late game.
I know how to play the late game. You see it clearly, right? Like early game, Raiden was so good, and then mid game and late game they fell off so hard.
And now they can
by
just
the bomb,
end the game.
By the moving bomb, look at it go.
Beautiful.
Look at it go. Well played, well played. Oh my god, the draft was like really good. I really like both the team has like Swash with the Impetus, and another team has Soulbind with Chain Frost. What do you want more? But the execution from Dio team was so good.
I think also the models were better on Dio team.
Yeah, I think they slightly favored the Dio.
But,
yeah, but not by much.
1-5 at bottom lane when,
okay.
When they attacked the Rex, right? I thought like Radiant's gonna win because of the illusion. And then one Schwarz on the two cores, it's like, oh my god, they turned the fight so badly. Damn, was a good fight.
That escalated quickly.
Quickly.
Just look at the graph. Minute 32. Radiant was ahead.
Yeah.
Minute 39. They were 35k behind and the game was over.
Well, look, mid game and late, they fell off so hard. Man.
Yeah, they played really disciplined and, you know, they had their game plan, they executed it, and it was hard for the Radiant to find a way back through that.
Godbar with most damage.
I totally agree with your opinion right there. That was really nice execution.
I think the problem was like the timing. The Kaya delayed the hex on Lich, which was the solution for the Wench.
Yeah.
And they bought the time for the Dire cores to come online with the remote mines. It was really well executed.
He's just the MVP for me in that game. He just made so much space with the mines. His laning kills were just impactful. There were so many times where like they overextended a little bit and he just got like four double kills, I think, through the course of the game. You can get pickoffs at the beginning of fights and just... It's really hard to fight that kind of lineup when you're automatically just starting 4v5.
Yeah, I'm also kind of agree and disagree with Hex Bill on Licht, because the PA always stand behind to swap him out. Even if you get Hex and they jump on the vents, they still swap him out.
Yeah, so but you have really... You have to think, like, they have Soulbind, which makes Hex twice as strong as it is, normally.
But that's so good game, man. That's so good game to watch. Holy fuck.
Yeah, it was a good game.
Well,
it was an awesome game to watch.